No, I just got a cookie.
Yo,
Pascal. Oh, you're
so
going
you
to.
know, did you have Black Ops 2?
What?
Did you have Black Ops 2?
Yeah.
Okay, you
not
know the
for,
overpowered
not
shotgun?
For PlayStation.
Okay, you know the overpowered shotgun in the Remington from Black Ops 2?
Yeah.
Yeah, so essentially, they made a replica of that gun, but it sort of has like double range, so it's even more overpowered.
Well, you have it.
It's the first shotgun, so everybody has it unlocked.
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah.
Alright, is my audio going through?
I think so. Problem. Yeah, you're
okay,
right,
yeah. Well, I was making sure it was going through on the Twitch. Alright. In-game save. Oh, yeah, that's right. Sorry, getting a headache in-game. Yeah, I give up.
Oh, dude, someone... So, I was the last person alive. I killed a couple guys, so I ended up getting a Wavy. And then I literally see them all around me. So I pulled up the UAV, and then I just turn around and shoot this guy because I knew he was chasing me down. And then, but of course, right as I turn around, the guy in front of me turns around and shoots me with the SMG. No, but that guy was chasing me down.
Oh, someone's watching.
Oh no, me and some of the other teams, we both have HCXDs. It's like the RCXD, but different. Slightly different.
Gotcha.
Jason Bourgeois yeah, is ready to go exploded. Here as we begin just the third. Exploded.
Jason Bourgeois. Alright.
Now a
we're
fastball
back
to start the third
show,
that misses. It's
2014,
ball one.
And this is my franchise once again. My OP franchise.
Off the plate again. 2-0 now.
Only had Robinson can
second base. If I got a yo, I almost caught Adam with a shotgun. Almost.
Shot foul. Ooh, nice job.
Here's the 2-1 pitch. Oh, but then I failed, so you know, not nice job.
He's fallen behind down 3-1.
Cause
four pitches.
I was in a corner,
slow,
and then
fast,
I saw like
slow.
On a corner of there was like a wall
here.
And a door in the middle, and I was about to I could see like this guy's like arm, just barely. So I was trying to shoot him, but it wouldn't let me. And then I had to like, go in there and kill him, but then someone came behind me.
Oh,
and
that
this
blew.
Is fouled back and out of play.
Yeah, I'm getting destroyed. My teammates aren't that good. 1-7-2, and they're going 2-3, 1-3, 0-0, 0-3, 0-3.
There's a swing,
0-3.
And he didn't quite get all of this as it sent down to
bad.
Batista and Wright.
Yeah.
One down.
That's the thing about the beta is that like half the teammates you get are terrible.
Man retired now for the shortstop, Jose Iglesias.
Half of them are like really good, and the other half are just poop.
Yeah.
And a high strike
oh,
there, 0-1.
Yeah.
One out, nobody on.
Come on, snipe, please work.
That misses to the Cardinals shortstop, and it's even at 1-1.
Wow. Mm-hmm. To go
helping interest. Him out here as he swings and misses to fall behind a ball and two strikes.
And if you're going to go after that pitch, you got to be thinking right
ooh,
field.
Wow.
Oh, my God. My teammates are
off of that one a little.
And he got him.
So you're streaming MLB?
Yeah.
Cool.
So bases
you got
empty it? Here with two gone.
Yeah.
Bring
well,
in
I'm doing my
franchise.
I'm not
baseman,
doing like
Prince
a my third.
They'll
like
start
what,
with
a
ball. Too low that time.
Yeah.
It's ball
I've
one.
I've actually never played MLB, so what is franchise in comparison to other games?
Franchise is like
and the young prince
you
of it
play
as
a whole team,
you
don't just play as one
foul
player.
Into the seats
but then,
the right
oh,
side.
So like, you're playing with other people?
Now the one
yeah,
one coming to
but like
field.
I...
Okay.
No. You're playing... Well, I mean,
spot.
You can
just
play online, but there's
there.
Also like
don't
the computer
down the
mode.
Middle because we know
which
you
is
okay.
What I do.
Why don't you play online?
3-1.
It's confusing. I mean, at least I think it's confusing.
Okay, fair enough. Yeah. Teammate is dead. Teammate, yep, teammate died.
Not surprisingly here, this is on the ground to the right side.
Do you have a bench warfare?
Throw on to Ortiz, and that'll retire the side.
Do you have a bench warfare?
1, 2, 3, yeah. Go the Cardinal.
Are you going to get Black Ops 3?
David Ortiz makes his way to the plate probably to get a start here in the bottom of
I don't think
three.
I'm getting a beta. I think I'll probably just get it when it comes out. I won't even pre-order it.
I didn't pre-order yet, but I'm going to, because my friend gave me a code, because he's nice. Look, he said he wanted me to give him $20 for it, but in the past, I've given him, like, $20 codes, so I asked for it for free and like, sure.
Oh, cool.
Gets a piece here as this is pushed far off to the right side. Price ready with the 0-1. Line hard, deep in the left. Vesaido is going to get there as he backs up to put it away, and there are two gone now. So bases are empty here with two gone, and set to stand in the still very imposing figure of the three-time MVP, Alex
Finally, McKinnon actually did something.
Now a ball lifted high in the air towards shallow right center field. Hart nice. Right there. As he puts this one away, the side is retired. Quick work there.
Who are you playing as?
Stand in now to get
us playing
going
as
here
the
in the
Mets,
fourth.
But I drafted, so like none of my players are actually on the Mets.
Well, that pitch isn't going to light up the radar gun,
fair
but
enough.
It's been effective.
Like, I didn't draft
well,
a single player.
If you get that good movement and put it in the right spot, it's plenty good enough to do the job.
Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's 1-1. Takes a look at a changeup there, and it's a ball and two strikes now. And the pitch. And this is swung on and missed that time by Hart as he becomes out number one.
Diane Vesiedo
will step in. 0-1 with a run scored thus far.
Did you feature us as one of your featured channels?
In oh, not yet, sorry.
The first pitch fastball.
Yeah, I featured
you. Oh,
that last pitch was
yeah,
number
just like
50 already.
Ago.
The 1v3, and if they win the round, I lose the game.
Part of the plate ties him up, and it's 1-1.
And SND, it's SND too.
Got in his kitchen, big time right there.
Cool.
On they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself.
You know, not in the best position.
Yeah, he hasn't shown that he's been able to resist those inside pitches. He may as well just keep going in there and hope he keeps chasing.
Oh my God!
Hey, Mom.
Dude, this one, he's literally, as soon as I get off the bomb, he runs to the place he's going to kill me from. That was one, that I was running to. So.
Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way, but he'll barely have to move out there and right as he hauls this one in for the second out.
Yeah, I think I'm going
to
get off soon.
Empty here with two gone, and here's the powerful Vernon Wells.
All right.
And he gets ahead 0-1.
Real good lateral.
It won't take too long though, so I still
want to
play a bit more.
That pitch is
well, I think I'm
because like
my franchise games
so
take a long
throwing.
Time. Like
that's
one
taken.
Game took 45
now
minutes.
0-2.
Jeez.
Plus, like my whole family's home. I mean, maybe going out to dinner. So.
Well hit high in the air and deep to center field.
Yo, I literally go 10-4. My teammates go 4-5, 4-6, 3-2, 1-6, 0-6. Really?
Ryan Ludwig will lead things off here in the right home here. Half of the fourth. Right.
Ryan Ludwig hit a grand slam.
Ooh, dude, I got a suppressor on my sniper.
Suppressors are only good on snipers, because when you're sniping, it doesn't have to be blocked.
Uh-huh. And this sniper is a confirmed headshot to the ribs and above. And usually it's a confirmed headshot. I don't know, not confirmed one shot to like the entire body. Like it says headshot to to ribs and above, but it's a sense it feels more like a headshot. I mean a one shot too.
Center.
Like anywhere in the body. Bourgeois maybe some of the feet.
Comes on now and he has it one
yeah.
Down.
Maybe.
Well, he gets you out there. But
it's like a
Moors.
It's a bolt action rifle too. So.
Guys are really putting together some good
essentially is a Moors.
So
Derek Norris.
But you know what's strange? They had, so they had this one snow map in the beta. Not in the beta. You know, I got the pre-releases at like Gamescom and stuff like that.
Yeah, like E3 and stuff.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And it showed like all the games they like YouTubers that came play it. One of the maps was like you could play it back at the E3 and stuff, and it's not in this. It's not in the beta. I don't know why. There's only three maps in the beta, and that's not one of them. Oh, you think it would be, right? Because if they have the map, like, finished, then why not let us play it?
Yeah. I think I have a high angle. Fair to say. Attacking me in soccer, and now it hurts.
Manny Machado will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth. And that one's in on the hands to start the inning. It's ball one. And he gets around on the fastball here as this is hit fairly well out toward left field. But he's going to haul this one in on the run as he winds up just shy of the wall for the first down. So one away here with the bases empty, and that'll bring in the all-star catcher, Brian McCann. Now started to go down after it, and he couldn't hold back. It's strike one. And this is fouled back.
Come on,
and
get sniped. Oh, I could have got the guy, but I missed him. I'm sort of mad at myself now.
Oh, and he dusted him off the plate that time. Some mind games being played now. It's one and two.
Yes, I got him.
He wasn't going to get his arms extended.
This shotgun has insane range. It's like 20 feet range.
Dive in left, but he can't get it. It'll get by
him. It's like the Olympia. Better.
And he's in there easily at second with a one-out double.
Oh, I got you. All right.
I love the Olympia, dude. That was Josh so Rutledge. Good. That gun was so fun to use. I was bad with it, but it was fun to use.
A ball and no strikes.
And point.
I always use that gun in zombies. The double was his third of the season. I'd always buy that as my wall gun.
Mm-hmm.
And this winds up inside for a ball, 2-0 now.
A couple of tight pitches here to start this at bat. You can't really say you're getting squeezed.
You can be rejecting me.
Couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane to the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike.
You're not Bay.
Hit hard towards the hole.
Does not equal
Bay. And that's by him into right field for a base hit. And the runner from second will stay put at third, so they're runners at the corners now with one away.
I need a ground ball here, guys.
Jason Bourgeois will stand in. He flew out his last time up. On the ground is short. And that's through for a base hit.
Oh, that's a run. Oh, my gosh.
Jose Iglesias.
3v2? 2v3? Come on, 2v2. You got this, teammates.
Just so you know, in your videos, your audio doesn't come
swinging
through.
A ball hit on the ground.
Oh, yeah, I know. I don't
it's
talk.
0-2 now. Three runs, five hits, and no errors. Most people call me a squeaker.
Like, not most people, I'd say. Some people call me a squeaker, and my voice can be annoying at sometimes. And when I record my voice, I sort of sound retarded from my perspective, in my opinion. So, you know, don't really. Maybe in a couple of years, if I still have a channel.
Prince Fielder, see what he can do here with two on and two out.
Great. So
five.
The bomb's planted, and we have to defuse it. And my only teammate is AFK. Professional.
Foul tip at the plate, so right professional off the arm here. Of the catcher behind the plate. Ouch. A little bit outside. Two and one.
Oh my god, they're retarded. Thank you. Jesus, like, and right after the bomb exploded, this guy goes up and tries to shoot our teammate. Like, why? What, you think you could do it a little bit faster, right? That's why we don't have to wait like 20 seconds. Because if you can't find him anywhere, then check the spawn. Probably AFK.
Foul back. I get Prince Fielder out.
And just did get a piece of that one, so he stays alive here.
No, oh my, what? Are you kidding me? Full count. Are you kidding? Wow. And now the runners will get a head start here with two away. There's like, on these Black Ops 3 maps, like, essentially, everywhere you can pretty much fall off. Like, there's so many things to fall off on the maps. Like every map so far, you can fall off on. And so I'm going over a gap. I'm jumping over a gap. And this guy comes up from above me. I shoot him with my shotgun, like once, and he doesn't die. And then I fall down to the abyss, like, and I die because I ran into him in midair and I can't do anything. And then my teammate. So the guy would have probably fallen down into the abyss too and died, and it would have given me like assisted suicide, but. My teammate instead decides to shoot the guy, so I don't even get assisted anything. Like, really?
And he reaches for one out of the zone and misses rather badly for the first out.
Mike Trout will stand in, 0 for 2 thus far.
Come on, Trout. Face it here.
And quick wrists here as this is yanked down the third baseline. And this is past him at third, down the line. It's a fair ball.
In this game, though, you can literally, like, take a knife. You have to equip the combat knife. Like, regularly, you can, like, slam people with the back of your gun. And take a two-shot kill. But if you equip the combat knife, then you can just, like, run up to someone and stab it in their face. It's insane.
Wow.
Pitch out. Nothing doing.
In my t-shirt, at my bed.
5 runs, 6 hits, 1 error in the game for the Mets thus far. A look to first by Price, runner back standing.
Come on, Price, pitch the
look
ball.
Into McCann, the 1-1. Now a half swing here on the pitch inside, but it's a full swing in the eyes of the home plate umpire. Strike 2. On the ground now for Iglesias. This could be 2. Rutledge relayed a fielder. It's a double play. And Corey Hart will lead things off for the Redbirds here in their half of the sixth inning.
Right fielder, Corey Hart.
And a good fastball from Bedard. It's 0-1.
And you can see him trying to be a little bit more patient here. He's got 2 strikeouts already. But he's got to be careful not to fall too far behind.
Now a
fastball. I always thought that you had to pay for
away,
Twitch, so that's why I didn't start Twitch right away.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
But you had, like, my gosh.
Approach here to sign up. So far. He's not working from behind in the count like he has his first few at-bats.
I'm sort of stupid, because, So I thought our teammate, I thought there was, like, it was a 2v2, and then I think somehow our teammate either killed one of them and then, or he fell off the map. So I wasted my RTXD, HTXD, same thing.
And the sixth inning opens with a 1 away.
Yeah.
Diane Viciedo will stand in here, 0 for 2 with a run scored so far, and it's the outside corner. It's strike 1. Out in front of a curveball here as this is bounced on the ground to third. Throw on to first, and Bedard's got it working here. There are 2 away. Vernon Wells will stand in 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far.
Yo, it's so scary when you deploy a UAV and SMD because literally everybody's
there,
around
no
you.
No balls and a strike.
Because there's so many, like, it's 66, so of course, like, once you, if you deploy, like, mid-match, then you notice how close everybody is to you.
In there, and he's in control.
So scary.
When he starts leaving that curveball up, that's a sign he's getting a little tired out there. He's got to be able to get on top of that pitcher. He's going to get hurt.
And he couldn't get him to chase the 0-2 fastball. It's 1-2.
Not a real good 0-2 there. You don't necessarily want it in the zone, but you do want to at least give him something to think of.
No.
Meanwhile, this ball is into right center, and that ought to be good enough for extra bases. And he is in the second with a 2-out double. So a runner at second.
Thank you, teammate. I love you.
And standing in now, the third baseman, Manny Machado. Now a check swing, but he makes contact and hits it out in front of the plate. And nothing will come with a two-out double as the inning is over.
Well, that's going to be it for Bedard.
David Ortiz will dig in now as he'll lead things off for the Mets in their half of the sixth.
The pitcher.
And this pitch just about saws him off as he can't get extended at all. That's strike one.
Yeah, he really pulled off of that one. And that's not the kind of swing we're accustomed to seeing from a guy like him.
Especially starting off an at-bat. Now the 0-2 from Bryce.
So 1-2. Somehow magically it went from immediately a 3-2 to a 2-2.
My count right now should be 3.
Oh my god, what?
And yet another foul ball here. Probably should have just got walked off with pitching.
I have an 0-2 count.
Really? Dude, I had my, you know how in Black Ops 3 now there's like specialist abilities and weapons and stuff like that? I could use a specialist ability that would have teleported me back, but it just, I just forget to use it, and I end up getting demolished.
They start thinking about being a little more fine later on in the game. And these guys start thinking, hey, you know what? I'm just going to go up there and jump.
See, the only one
I would ever remember to use is one where
you, as soon as you die, you just right where you died. Because then it would be off my mind. Like, I wouldn't be thinking about having to use it in the actual game, because when I die, then I can think about it.
And a good two-strike swing here as he's been fighting off some tough pitches, but the count will remain at 0-2. And he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. And he will recover in time to get it over to first. Nicely done there as they record the second out. Alex Rodriguez, the third baseman, will stand in here hoping to at least put a ball in play here this inning.
Oh my god.
And a miss on a pitch in the dirt.
Legit. Somehow?
No, oh, he's got him beaten right out of the palm of his hand now. 10 balls.
Two strikeouts already here in the inning. And now he gets the third guy to go after a first pitch out of the strike zone.
And A-Rod has a base hit.
Oh
Ryan
my
Ludwig
god.
Ludwig will dig in. One for two to this point in the ballgame. And this is fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul.
I'm a tryhard, so I'm just using the Remington with a overkill Moore's thing. It's not really like a Moore's, but it's like I told you, it's like the bolt action thing that like one shots.
And this is swung on and bounced up
the thing I love about Advanced Warfare is that you have so much variation. And I like how they're trying to come back with that in this game. Like, you know, they have like the gunsmith where you can put like five or six attachments on a gun. So, I like it.
Yeah.
See, the thing with these high infantry is that I just get bored of them too fast. Well, the guy is just the same thing over and over again.
Has opted to roll with his starter here to begin his half of the seventh.
And that pitch count is a concern, so he may get the chance to finish this inning off and then call it a night.
But _FTW.
Why? Thank you. What were you saying?
No, nothing.
Now a swing and a ground.
My brother
ball
is attempting this off.
This will wind up foul. Still 0-2.
Wow, dude. So I'm shooting someone, and right behind me, this guy comes up and punches me in the back. Wow.
And the shift will not amount to much.
If you have no secondary or no primary, you have this.
The catch on the warning track. Josh Rutledge will stand in. He's 1-for-2 so far. Well, now here comes the Mets manager, Terry Collins, on his way to the mound. And that's going to do it for his starter, Eric Bedard.
Yeah.
And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped off. Bases are empty, one man out.
Get underwater shotgunned. That's how we roll.
And this one's hit on the ground,
underwater
but foul.
Shotgun.
Job of holding up on the low ball there, and it's 1-2.
And now, as a hitter, 1-2, you've got to be thinking right center field.
No!
Take a little swing out, try to drive something the other way.
Here's the pitch.
I'm going up after this game.
Now this is swung out, and here's another fly ball out to right field.
Going
to take it is Bautista, and he's got it.
I'm in the seventh inning right now. And then we got it.
Okay.
Jason Bourgeois.
So it's still a while to go.
He singled home a run his last time.
Not really. I'm winning, so there's not. So if I keep winning, there won't be a bottom of the ninth.
Oh yeah.
Comes back with the cutter and gets it by him. One and one now.
Swinging at the cutter outside.
No, of course. As soon as I turn around, is it? What? What the hacker? You know whenever someone who is you in COD, of course it's a hacker.
Here's a
swing
and a ground ball.
COD logic. Everybody is hacker.
Is that even things at 2-2?
Because as soon as I turn around, this guy comes up and shoots me.
And the slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
Well, that's an opportunity wasted on the mound there. A hitter's got to be defensive on 2-2, but that was so far outside, he didn't even have to worry about chasing it.
Payoff pitch one more time.
I've had teammates die from drowning in SNU.
Right,
like,
in
are you that stupid?
And
you're going to die from drowning? Yeah. Everybody takes a little bit of damage from drowning. Like, even I do. I take some damage. But if you die from drowning, it's pretty sad. Cause like you have to be in the water. You have to like be taking a lot of damage. You have to take like
Iglesias
at least four hits
short
to be killed by drowning.
And a good throw gets him one gun.
And like it's usually like
nice.
6 to 8 seconds in the water, and then like
and
the
out
next second you'll get first drowning hit, then couple and maybe in a second or two. I say in the second, then you get another drowning hit. So 4 or 5 drowning hits, then you get killed.
Gotcha.
I don't understand how you managed to die from drowning though. Like, is it really that hard?
Howie Hamilton will dig in now, hitless in his 2 at bats so far.
It's pretty obvious when you're drowning.
Oh, and he lays one down here, and this is going to be a tough play. A bare hand pickup by
Machado.
Oh,
man. I thought that bunt would be smart.
A three-pitch inning. And the Jose Iglesias will get us going now in the top half of the eighth.
All right, so now we're going to warm up and toss. No. Sit down. Stretch and toss.
Kyle Farnsworth will be summoned from the bullpen now as he'll take over to start inning number 8.
Yeah, Farnsworth pitching.
Jose Iglesias will get us going now in the top half of the 8th. First pitch is a changeup
for
a called strike.
And here's where you don't need to be an RBI guy. You don't need to be a home run guy. You have to be a leadoff guy. Just get on base somehow to give that tying run on deck a shot.
Come on, teammates, please cover me. Help me defuse the bomb.
And he'll take this to the bag.
There we go.
Is the party private or?
Prince Fielder will stride in.
It's private, but.
And a high strike
invite him
to begin the at bat. It's 0-1.
Getting that first pitch strike is so important against a guy like this.
Feeding parkour. I suggested him
ahead in the count and not let him dictate the at bat.
Does he will he subscribe to our YouTube channel?
Just got a
guys,
we only need
one more sub.
On
the YouTube channel.
It's fine.
Well,
wait, one more sub on your YouTube channel for what?
Then we're gonna hit our goal. Our goal was before school starts to have 20 subs. Well, at the beginning of the summer it was get 25 subs and 1,000 views. But as the summer went on, we said, yeah. Because we try to upload every day, but then, like, stuff happened where someone was putting up every day and stuff.
Yeah, so, I understand how you get 25 subs, but 1,000 views, it seems reachable, but it's very doubtable. Did you invite him?
No, I'm in a game now. I'm going to go and
there. Okay. Do you mind if you join this party? Because you're going to go, right?
Trying to jam him with the first pitch slider, but it's in a bit
later
too tight for ball one. Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball, 1-1.
Straight paint at 94 miles an hour. Not a lot of movement there, but it's right on a dime.
And this is swung on and sent down the
so guys, as
first.
We were saying before, we only need now the goal is by the end of September. And if you guys follow us on Twitter, you'll see I have posted it on Twitter. The goal is by the end of September to have 20 subscribers and to have 500 views. Mike now, Trout, I just checked a little bit before this live stream, and we're at 19 subs and 450 views. So we just gotta, you know,
and
keep going. Because we're almost there. Almost. Trout's up.
Grounded softly to the left
so
side.
If we hit the goal, we'll try and make like a special video or something. For the first down.
This guy's one of those unsung type pitchers. He's not the setup guy, he's not the closer, but these are the guys that keep you in the ball games, and he's doing the job here.
Now a ball lined into left field. That's a base hit. Oh, and this goes right past him. He'll get it into second.
Oh. Damn.
And he'll scramble back to the
I pressed the wrong button.
Safely.
I was still holding it down.
So some real problems
I think
there
if he didn't
throw
it, I
would
have been
okay. Runner is second, one away. And here's the still
yeah, that,
dangerous left-handed
oh,
bat of David Ortiz. Yes. No lead to speak of. At second, here's the pitch. Swing, hard hit ball to second.
That can advance a run.
And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow. Jose Bautista will dig
right,
in with a very
see.
Important insurance run 90 feet away at third.
I'm taking this pitch. No, I'm not.
Oh, and this fastball is absolutely
I was like, yeah, no.
Center field. Does he
so
have
was like,
to get out of here?
I want to make sure Koji Uehara is ready.
Alex Rodriguez will stride in. He singled in his last plate appearance.
There you go. We'll let him keep. We'll have him warm up, so that way if Farnsworth gives up a run, Koji will get the save.
Fouled back.
I was like, I'm taking the pitch, and then I was like,
two out, nobody on.
No, I'm not. That was awesome. That was deep too.
Swing and a ground ball towards the hole from deep in the hole, and this is in the dirt, but Fielder
nice
does just
scoot.
What his name him. Diane Vicedo will start things off here in the ninth. No sign of the closer just yet here in a four-run ball game.
And
yeah, I think
guy.
They'd love to get him a day off here.
Fedora
so they're gonna hope that his services
he
aren't required to finish this one off.
Third. We just tacked
and
on
that swung on and
so
fouled straight back.
There's a victory for him.
The nothing in one pitch is bounced on the ground to Jeter
at shortstop.
The first
base,
the
out the
out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Vernon Wells will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs. Now a fastball that couldn't quite find the zone. It's ball one. Too much bite on the sinker, and he's behind 2-0 now.
And that's right where you want to be throwing those sinkers, but he's doing a good job at the plate, not chasing.
And wow, that looked to be well inside, but it's a called strike. 2-1 now.
Well, he's been in a tough stretch offensively, and this sure ain't gonna help.
Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul.
Oh, I thought they were down in the final shake.
And look out as that one ran in and got him.
Oh, that's the last thing you want to do is put a guy on base right before you got to face a great slugger at the plate. Well, that ain't going to make things easier.
I did not know that.
Manny Machado is in with one away now as he swings and misses here at strike one.
Well,
they haven't been afraid of
in the comments,
right
guys are putting marks.
They made him have to swing the bat.
Put, like, all those things.
Tried to get him to go after the slider, but it's one
last
and one.
Last channel I pasted just marks because I was featuring him.
And a half-hearted attempt that time as he broke the plane of the plate. It's a ball.
All the featured channels
now
are only channels that we play with.
And he gets
we're
a piece of this one to
like
foul it toward the backstop. Here he comes again, 1-2.
Swing and a hard ground ball to third.
One there.
On to first, and he rolls the double fly ball to end it here as this ball game is over.
That's the ball game.
I think this one was pretty much over before it started.
Let's see. I want to go to the
this one out of reach right from the get-go.
That Ryan Lovick's grand slam. This game would have been tied.
And the Mets were given a big boost tonight by the performance of this man.
Ryan Lovick. One hit. Biggest hit of the game, though.
Player of the game.
Yeah, and I think we probably could have given this award to three or four different people, but you definitely can't overlook his contribution. He really played a great ball game tonight.
I'm just going to quickly see if... Is there like a thing to say how long... So that one's... Oh, okay, 35 minutes. Kyle Lewis is on fire. Ludwig. Okay. Clint Barnes still doesn't have a hit. Wong has it. Hamilton has it. Clint Barnes just can't produce. Just can't. Shame. He can't produce. I'm digging the uniform. They don't really wear the black uniforms that much anymore. Get in my t-shirt, rack my bed all night long. Hey, that's not a good ball. Oh, that. Because I have no idea how pissed I would have been if that was like during the actual game. Warm up's really pissing me off. I hope that doesn't happen during the game. None of those balls should have been called strikes. None of those balls should have been called balls. They all should have been called strikes.
Josh Rutledge, a move towards the batter's box as we're just about set to get underway tonight.
I think this is episode 2, though. I'll be sure.
And a first pitch sinker is over for strike one. That's in there as well. It's a quick 0-2 count.
At the very least, he's showing some patience here to start the ball game. Well, that'll be important for him as we move along tonight.
Might have been looking to find that outside corner, but he couldn't quite get it there. It's 1-2. Well, the mercury has dipped under 50, 49 degrees here at first pitch. swing and an easy one for the first baseman. And they'll just tag him out along the first base line. Jose Iglesias will stand in, and you see the average there, up over 300 to start the new season.
The next two games,
and here's a fastball that he takes the other way onto fairly deep right.
Finds it.
There to take it is Bautista, and he's got it for out number two.
I'm going to try and sign you on this.
Get his first shot down. He's seen that average climb a bit here recently, thanks to what he's done over the course of these last five ball games.
What I have to do is I have to sign like a outfielder.
And he's probably not going to throw too many first pitch changeups. That's a pretty darn good call.
So then I can at least have a lefty outfielder.
And this is swung on and lifted down the left field line, but it'll get back into the crowd as he jumps ahead of him now, 0-2. Oh, he took a big swing that time as he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory on the right side.
This
will not be caught. It's a foul ball.
I feel like Ludwig's high.
And he just gets a
I'd probably rotate the four outfielders every day. Every game, I should say.
And the shift will not amount to much here as this is lifted in the air out to right field. And Bautista will make the catch to retire.
He had a home run yesterday. But, like, someone's slumping, then I have a fourth powerful outfielder.
Billy Hamilton
line.
Will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the
1%.
First. Now a bunt attempt here. Throw to first will get him as they pounce on it quickly to snuff out
Billy
the bunt
Hamilton
attempt.
I think Trout will.
So the base is empty here with one away, and standing in the ever-dangerous Mike Trout. Line hard into left, but pretty much right at the left fielder as he takes it in for the second out. Jose Bautista will stand in, and you see there, he's been scorching hot these past few games. Fouled back. And just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. Mets go down 1-2-3. We've played an inning. No score.
Right fielder, Corey Hart.
Corey Hart is in to start things off as he looks at a ball to start the inning 1-0. 1-0 pitch now. Swung on and lined softly up the middle. Whoa, but that's
Kyle
just soft defense as he spears it for the out. Brian McCann will make his way in now. He drove in two of his club's three runs in last night's game. And he catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing in one.
And you know, this is a guy that loves the ball down and in. It's one of the locations he really covers well, so they're going to want to mix their spots here.
Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground at the left side. Throw on to first will get him. Score it 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are two away now.
All right. So far, I've only had five pitches.
Diane Vicedo
last inning, I had
is at
10
the plate
pitches.
Now, and he takes a cold strike.
So, hopefully,
this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
And I'll tell you, being in that two-strike hole is not the spot you want to be in against a guy like this.
But
and this will be fouled away. Now, another 0-2. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. And he'll pounce on this quickly to tag him out. David Ortiz will stand
Ortiz,
and obviously one to be careful with, as you see there, currently leading the senior circuit in long balls. Swung on and missed. It's 0-1. And speaking of the National League's home run leaders, there they are on your screen. Now a pitch swung on and missed as the count goes to 0-2 to Ortiz.
You've got a cold night. The
Yeah, 20 games, 9 home runs. Well. 10
so
home runs.
So you can afford to take a few more chances in the strike zone and challenge some guys. In that case, up in the strike zone.
Duh.
Hit hard to the right.
I love how that
one. Hooking just foul by a matter of inches that time. And they take him out of the zone here, and he obliges. Not the greatest of swings there.
Almost
the first out. David Ross will stand in, and you see what he's done over the past four games. As hot as they come.
I'm not happy with my catcher cut.
And that one
and
missed 0-1.
Yeah, and you know, this is a spot where you just have to make him bring the ball down. It's very difficult to do anything positive when it's up that high.
And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away.
Not that low stuff.
Looked like he went out of the zone that time as this is skied toward the right side of the infield. Therefore, it is
not
Rutledge, and there are two away now. Colton Wong will stand in, getting the start here despite being out of the lineup last night. And a pitch down that swung on and sent to second base. Throw to fielder at first will take care of him, and that'll be that. So they go down without a whimper here. Vernon Wells. Stand in now to lead things off. 7, 8, and 9 here to start the third inning.
And maybe one of these guys can break this string of six straight retired to start the ball game.
So we have
third
a 10 pitch inning
with a
and a 9
that's
pitch
looked
inning.
At here for ball one. In there, one and one.
Before 31 pitches.
And he finds a way to catch the zone here. It's 1-2.
Now you can't look for a specific pitch. You just got to protect the plate.
You get him?
And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. And here's a ball hit in the air.
Teeth.
And the leadoff man retired now in the park in third. Pedro Florimond. We'll dig in for the first time here, looking to change his fortunes a bit as he's seen that average dip these last four or so games. Pitch to the plate is a sinker for a called strike one.
I tell you, he's got a good pace, a good tempo to him out there right now.
That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
And I know it's your first at-bat of the ball game, and you want to work the count a little, but those were two pretty good pitches to have a rip at.
I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Cardinals have been held out of the hit column here. Here's a ball hit pretty well and carrying to deep right. And this will be taken in out there just a few steps in front of the track. And there are two away now.
I thought for a second that this might make a dent both the hit and the run column, but he didn't quite get all of it. It's probably the best swing, though, they've had so far.
And he'll hold off on the slider here to start the at-bat. It's ball one.
Can't get a desired strikeout before 31 pitches.
And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike. Ah, and he took something off of it there. It's 1-2.
Fine, I'll take 32 pitches.
And it's to 2-2 now. The base is empty and two gone here in the inning.
Don't do this.
Just did get a piece of that one, so he stays alive here. On the ground a second.
All right. Well, even though you went through over the desired amount of pitches.
Ichiro Suzuki.
So pitching a perfect game.
Ichiro Suzuki
is now up. Damn, I'm at 35 pitches. He's at 13. What's wrong with this pitcher? Got
6
pitches.
Six down to start the game.
Like that.
Now a slider in on the hands, and he's lucky that one didn't come and get him.
And I think that might have been a first. The first ball they've taken the entire game.
Damn it!
Sound the trumpets.
Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball. 1-1. Gets under this one as this is hit high and pretty deep out there to center field. under it as well as he puts it away for the first down.
Well, we got another person watching. Good, so I got Cardinals, Marlins, Marlins.
So with
Marlins,
one gone, a reminder that New York Mets baseball continues all season long here on MLB The Show. As you take a look there at where the three of us will be in the week ahead. Swing and a liner toward right center. And he couldn't quite get high enough to pull that one down. It's into right center, a base hit.
All right.
Clint Barmas will get his first shot here with the runner at first. Barmas now and one away.
To get a base hit. That's pretty bad.
A look at Jeter, now the pitch. Good off-speed pitch. Got him out in front for strike one.
Got to turn on that.
Now a swing and a ground ball, but this will wind up a foul ball, strike two.
Still
runner at
first,
first here, one man
season.
Out. Here's Latos now on 0-2. Swing and a ground ball to short.
How did I know?
He can't pick it up cleanly. But he'll recover in time.
Really,
that
should have been
a
double
runner at second, so a heads
Whenever
up
I click
play
R2
to get that second out.
To try and make him speed up.
The runner going down the drain right there. He's in a little bit too much of a hurry to get rid of his throw. So once he bobbles it, the chance for two goes right out the window. Fortunately, he is able to re-grip it in time to hustle it over there to second and save the force out.
Billy Hamilton swings and misses there, so he's down 0-1.
Just overmatched him there.
And this is swung on and lifted down the left field line, but it'll get back into the crowd as he jumps ahead of him now, 0-2.
25 pitches. Either we got to get a man on or we got to take.
Now a fastball swung on.
Okay,
missed,
or not.
And that is out number three.
Or not.
Mets leave one. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. Josh Rutledge will stand in to begin their half of the fourth with his guys still looking for their first hit of the ball game.
Yeah, still looking for their first base runner, too. Nine up, nine down.
40. Oh, man, I'm still getting screwed on balls.
Yeah, and when your team still doesn't have a hit, you appreciate a call like that once in a while.
And this is fouled back and out of play. Swing and a ball hit hard to third.
Oh, come on. You got to get in front of that ball. Great. I hope Clint Barmes is happy. I'm dropping him when this game's over.
Jose Iglesias will stand in now, and he'll likely have a look down to third to see if anything's up here with nobody out.
Actually, technically, he's still a hitter now.
And you know, down there at third base, he absolutely wants another shot at a ground ball. Something to try and make up for that error.
Now an off-speed pitch well inside, and it forces him to bounce away from danger.
Sometimes if you let that changeup go too soon, it'll take off on you. He's lucky that didn't hit him.
Now a swing and a high fly ball, and this one has some carry on it to deep right field. Under it is Bautista as he makes the play for route number one. And he will hasten his way back to first, where he's in there safely. Prince Fielder will dig in here. He flew out his first time around. Swing and a ball hit on the ground. No runs, no hits, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop.
Fielder better ground into a double play. There should be two outs, except Clint Barnes can't even field a freaking ground ball.
Well, that's a pretty good spot to try and lock him up inside, but you know, he can turn on that location if that's out over the plate.
And this is fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. Runners on the move for second. Now a ball lined to the right side. In there, a base hit.
Oh, if that throw was on target, he was out.
So two men are
there
on
goes
with
the
one
no-hitter.
Man out. And standing in is the right fielder, Corey Hart. And a good spot for that pitch
that
is it's
was on
chopped
target,
foul.
He's out and the no-hitter is still intact. Intact.
Swing and a ball lifted into straightaway center. Trout is there, two gone.
Oh, that's how you jump R1.
Brian McCann will get a shot here with two on and two out here in the fourth. First pitch is a sinker for a called strike one.
Boy, his control has been outstanding so far. And there's another pitch right on the block.
That's on the inside corner to put him behind here. Nothing in tune.
Well, no taking now. He's going to have to swing the bat.
Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground to second. On to first, and the Redbird rally goes for naught as that ends the inning. Mike Trout will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. And he goes and chops this one out towards second. And a high throw that time, but Fielder's able to go up and get it for the first out. Jose Bautista will try it again. Set down on strikes his first time. First pitch has him dancing to avoid it. It's ball one.
Yeah, I don't think this is a guy you want to mess with here. He can hurt you in more ways than one.
And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. It's a ball and a strike. I changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. One and two
balls. That's disgraceful. He really pitched
it going good. It just takes a nosedive right at the end.
Legit, he's actually probably pitched 5 balls. He's down on strikes for the second time
tonight. Very quickly, 5 pitches and 2 outs here in the fourth. Those are the kind of innings you love to have if you plan on working deep into a ball game.
David Ortiz will stride in again. He struck out swinging his first time. Oh, hit sharply as this is pulled into right. Hart is there, makes the catch. Diane Viciedo will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth.
Left fielder, Diane Viciedo.
Here's a swing and a ground ball. And a diving effort there at third. Good way to bruise your ribs. How much for one of them ribs? It's a foul ball. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. And this ball will be chopped foul. Lays off that time, and it's 1-2. And he reaches out of his zone and misses rather badly for the first out. Vernon Wells will dig in. He popped out his first time. Swing and a hot shot toward third. And that gets down and ought to be good for extra bases. And this will find its way to the 335 sign. And he's in there easily at second with a one-out double. Pedro Florimon will try it again. He flew out his first time. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one.
We only got one out.
For Wells, the double was his third of the season here in this first month. Slider, and that's in there for strike two.
0-2, you gotta shorten up. Find some way at least to put the ball in play. You can't afford a strikeout here with an important run out there at second base.
And he gets under this one as the ball is skied into very shallow right. Under it is Wong, and there are two away now. Cesar Asturias will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Now this is driven out to deep right center. This could be trouble. And it is trouble that finds the gap for extra bases. And that'll drive in the run from second as they're on the board first. 1-0.
Not getting in fast enough.
Josh Rutledge will dig in now. Hitless in his 2 at-bats so far.
Josh.
A big roundhouse curveball in there for strike one. For Asturias, it's his 4th double here in this early part of the year. Up
so
and
it originally
here
started out
as
a very good day.
Danger.
And right now,
Clint Barnes
have any second
interrupted
thoughts
with
about
the
working
air.
Hard inside.
Took away
the
perfect
guy. Got the open base to protect.
And Prince Fielder took it away with
the play is made here to
the
end
hit.
The inning. David Ross. Stand in to start things out here in the home half of the fifth.
Now we don't even have
to
shut out.
Get the sense, Steve, that this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame to this point.
Yeah, they pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon. Not a lot to get excited about so far. And I think that's a credit to that man out there on the mound. He's
come
right through this lineup for the first 4 innings.
Colton Wong will stand in. He grounded out his first time. And he swings on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. No runs, just one hit. One error in the game for the Mets thus far. And a pitch up and in, right, keeping him
those
honest.
Are the
one and one.
You have to take. Guys, a third, two pitches in 5 minutes.
Oh, he goes right with this one as it's laced into left center field, and it'll get down for extra bases. And this will get to the wall now, out beyond the 385 sign. The relay. And now they've got him.
Oh my God.
Down, and they'll
what
slap
is
the
problem?
The rundown between second and third. Ichiro Suzuki will dig in here. He flew out his first time around. Swinging a ball pretty well hit out towards left center.
Freaking hate this game.
There and they go
this
down
is
in
awful.
Here as this side is quickly retired.
The controls are awful.
Jose Iglesias will get things started here in the top of inning number six. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one. Well, for that man right there, only the one run allowed. How discouraging is that when you're pitching your heart out and you're just not getting the support?
Well, the good pitchers really don't let it get to them. They know that it cuts both ways. Sometimes you give up five runs and your guys score you eight. You just have to focus on
great,
holding up your end of the bargain.
Runner at second now. Nobody out. And that'll bring in the slugging first baseman, Prince Fielder. Sinkers in there.
Great, so
no balls
double.
And a strike.
3-4-5 hitters
for Iglesias,
up. No out.
That's now seven doubles for him on the season.
So number two hitters. Supposed
that's in there as well. It's a quick 0-2 count. Any surprise they're attacking him like this? Those are two good pitches.
No, I think that's the way this guy operates. He won't back down out there, nor should he.
Just a touch outside, 1-2. Oh, not
that's
fooled.
A no doubter.
Bit by the changeup as he smokes this one to deep left field, and that one will not be coming back. A home run. Corey Hart will dig in
better,
now. He's
losing,
lined out and flied out in two trips. Now a fastball on the inside corner, and he takes a look at strike one. And here's a swing and a miss that time by Hart as he's in trouble now, down 0-2.
And on 0-2, I'd be shocked to see another fastball in the strike zone.
And they can't get Hart to chase there, but he's still behind, a ball and two strikes. Look out, and that'll give him a close
shake.
Can't imagine guys
count.
Like that too much.
Yeah, not too much indeed. You start getting into the danger area when it's up and in that high.
And Hart sends this one down the left field line, but this is going to hook into the seats. Foul. And this is swung on and missed that time by Hart as he becomes out number one. Brian McCann will stride forward now. He's bounced out a couple of times already here in the ballgame. Swing and a grounder fouled, and that almost took the first base coach along with it. Out in front a bit as this is pulled down the line to first. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and there are two away now. Dayan Viciedo will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips. Sinker runs outside to start the at-bat, 1-0. Swing and a ball hit out toward right center. Bautista is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Derek Jeter will come forward now to start out their half of the sixth, and they've found it rough sailing against this starter so far as he's yielded just two hits through the first five.
Not too many hard hit balls there either. He's had him off balance all game.
Fouled straight back. Cardinals get the bullpen started here as a right-hander's up and warming. 0-2 pitch to Jeter. And he goes the other way with a fastball as this is hit in the air toward the gap in right center. Under it is Wells as he puts it away for the first out. Clint Barmas will stand in. He reached on a fielder's choice his first time. Out in front here as this is pulled down the third base line. Throwing the dirt as this pops right up over his shoulder. Luckily, however, the first baseman will get his mitt on it, so there is no advance on the play. Billy Hamilton will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far. Now a swing, but not much behind it as this is lifted into shallow center. Iglesias will put this one away, and that's out number two. Mike Trout will step in. He's lined out and grounded out in two trips.
Very, very upset.
First pitch coming. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. And boy, was he ever
oh my god.
It's 0-2 now.
Freaking
a strike away
Matthews.
Now from getting through six shutout innings here, and that's no small feat against this lineup.
Oh, and he dusted him off the plate that time. Some mind games being played now. It's
this
1-2.
This count should be 3-0 right now.
Safe to say, guys don't care much for that location. That'll get you riled up the plate, no doubt.
And this is going to be a foul ball.
Four pitch walk.
And he'll fight just to stay alive here as this is fouled away.
All these fastballs outside the zone.
Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground is short. And
oh my god, the fucking button! Jesus Christ!
Strand one. They trail it here 3-0. Vernon Wells will lead it off here in the top of inning number 7. Lucas Harrell is into the ballgame now as he'll make his fifth appearance of the season here. Vernon Wells will lead it off here in the top of inning number 7. And that's in there for strike one.
Oh, but that's a strike.
Nice to get that call right out of the bullpen.
And that swung on and fouled straight back. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7. Pedro Florimon will stand in again. He's flown out in each of his first two plate appearances thus far. In there for strike one. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. On to first, and a good stretch over there is going to get him by a step for the second out. Cesar Esturiz will dig in now. 1-for-2 to this point. Here's the first offering. And a fastball misses here to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. Now a ball sprayed foul into the seats near third. And this is going to be fouled into the diamond level seats. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Now another 1-2. And he lays off the fastball away, so it's 2-2 now.
Ooh, there's a tough one to take right there on a 1-2 pitch, especially after fighting off so many pitches leading up to that one.
Now a ball hit sharply toward third. A diving try at third, but this is by him, a fair ball.
Oh, that's just a nice play out there in the corner. You know, with most guys, this is a sure double. But he might even have hit this ball a little too hard because they can get it back into the infield quickly, and that's going to hold him to just a single.
Josh Rutledge is at the plate now as he looks at strike one. And he lays off for ball one. Hit hard, but foul. And now a fastball is roasted into left field. That's a base hit. And he'll get in there safely at third. Second and third now with two gone. Jose Iglesias will try and cash in on this two-out rally as he's got a couple of men in scoring position with two away. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one.
Now he's going to have to punch his way off the ropes now.
Look out, 2-0 now.
That's what I'm
and he didn't even have to think twice about that one. And now he's got a good hitter's count here, 2-0.
And there's a swing and a miss, 2-1 now.
And if you're going to go after that pitch, you've got to be thinking right field. I think he just pulled off of that one a little.
Into
here's a fly ball now, lifted in the air out to right. Bautista is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. Jose Bautista will step in now to lead off the home half of the seventh.
Yeah, that ball's gone.
One hit high in the air.
Back-to-back nights for
that. And this one's going to make it the distance. That is a long home run.
Ninth of the year. Bautista's only one behind David.
He struck out and lined out in his first two at-bats. And this will be fouled away.
David, I would want to hit another one. Get a gap.
And I believe they'll say he broke the plane, as yes, he did. It's ruled a strike. Fouled back. And this is hit hard to the right side. Foul. And they tie up in proverbial knots there as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning. David Ross will dig in again. He popped up in his first plate appearance and flew out last time around. Swinging a ball hit softly on the ground. Throw on to fielder for out number two.
Favorite catchers in the game.
He was thrown out trying to stretch a double into a triple this last
time. Trout.
Starts him with a good rising
Trout's
fastball
really
there
good.
For strike
one. I won't lie.
Boy,
Trout,
he has been a
Trout's
first
really
strike
a
throwing
play.
Machine, hasn't he? He's hardly been behind in the count all game long.
I already
Filed
have time
back.
For the outfield.
Now pitch swung on and lined softly to short. Throw on to fielders in time, and with that, the
well, we got one run back.
Prince Fielder will stand in again as we flash you back to the middle innings here. This was a big blow, a two-run home run that really got his guys going. Heath Bell will come on and make his fourth appearance in this campaign. Prince Fielder will get us going now in the top half of the eighth. Fastball there from Bell as he gets ahead, nothing and one.
Getting that first pitch strike is so important against a guy like this. You have to be able to work ahead in the count and not let him dictate the at-bat.
And now a swing and a miss by the young Prince, and Fielder's gone for the first down. Corey Hart will stand in now, hoping to get on track as they've been able to neutralize his power out of the cleanup spot. 0-3 thus far. They set the target in, and this finds the inside corner for strike one. Hard hit towards center. Trout is there now, and he has it. Two gone. Brian McCann will try again. 0-3 thus far. In tight here with the first pitch fastball that's 1-0. And that's right there, and we're even at one.
And on the mound here, you got to make sure you pitch to the shift. You don't want to make it easier for a guy to go the other way on you.
Now, the shift won't matter here as this is skied out to center field.
Both
Crowd will get there, and he puts it away to Ichiro Suzuki will lead things off here in the bottom half of inning number 8. And there you see the right-handed hitting Ryan Ludwig as it looks like he'll be called upon to pinch hit here. First pitch to him here is hit on the ground to the left side as he doesn't waste any time. That's into left for a base hit. So a runner at first now with nobody out. And in steps Derek Jeter. There's a line drive that'll be over the head of Iglesias and on into left center field for a base hit. And now he has some trouble with it in center.
Second and third, no.
Hey, maybe some signs of life here in this inning. That's back-to-back hits now. A single followed by a double. And this might be the best rally they've had in the game so far. Clint Barman.
Plus now defensively,
in now
yeah,
what could be a real make-or-break situation.
You think at this point you have to get something out of this inning. The further you get into that bullpen, the tougher it's going to be to claw back from this deficit.
And a swing and a bouncing ball back up the middle.
Oh!
Throw on to first to be in time. But meanwhile, the lead shrinks to one here
so
on the RBI ground ball. Billy Hamilton will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
And a chance at redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate
like
appearances. He could make up for all of that with a base hit right here.
One out.
Damn,
runner
I thought
on third.
I really did think I was there, though.
Well, this is hit hard towards second, and he will
and
deliver one of the biggest
high
at-bats of the night. It's a base hit.
Repeat,
and
baby.
Break the tying run from third as we've got ourselves a brand new ball game now. So a runner at first now with one away, and standing in the ever-dangerous Mike Trout. And that, in fact, is going to wind up out of play, so a costly mistake there. Ball bounces and this one gets away. Throw goes to third and he is in there at third as the possible
so
go-ahead score
leads us to second.
That's a tough
and a
chance
wild
there behind the plate. This is a curve
yeah,
ball. You see him try to smother it, but
no,
this ball just eats him alive. That's going to let that runner move over to third now. And
the pass ball. Oh,
hit.
Wild pitch. So it closes
runner
away right
from third. Now the pitch. Change up here as this ball's grounded.
Well, anyway,
foul.
I'm pretty sure wild pitches count as errors. Yeah, I think they do.
And just lucky to make contact on that.
And we only got one out,
foul.
So all Trout needs is once again get the ball out of the infield.
Swing and a miss. He struck him out.
All right.
A big out there as the go-ahead run stays at third with two
Jose
gone
Bautista,
now.
This man that started this thing
Jose
off
Bautista will have a chance here in a crucial spot with the go-ahead run just 90 feet away. And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul.
Right now, he's the next hero. Let's see if he can finish it.
Big uppercut
no,
there as
he's
he
not
popped this straight up, and I mean way up there on the left
he's
side of the infield. Sturris is there now to put this one away for the third out as they'll strand that potential go-ahead run at third base. So two runs. Ryan Ludwig will stay in the ball game now and take
Ludwig
over in left field.
Now playing left field.
Staying at left.
Alex Rodriguez is going to go ahead and stay in the ball game and
third.
Play third now.
Just get Kirby.
Here we go with inning number 9 as the first pitch misses for ball 1. The man you see here out for a second inning of work, and he becomes the pitcher of record now in a tie ball game.
Yeah, he pitched well last time around. No reason to think that he can't do it again.
All over the place to
okay
start the ninth. It's 3-0 now.
questionable call on the previous pitch
also
really
not
changes the at-bat because
I strongly,
I should have been a good second. 3-0, and tide is not working in his favor.
And this is fouled back and out
but
of play.
Let's make a comeback here on Machado.
Now a swing and a fly ball. And foul. Rolled foul off to the left, so they'll try it again. The next 3-2. And he's just going to make him throw as many pitches as he can as he fouls another one away, and it's still folded 3-2. And here's a big swing as he sends this
one
in the air toward deep center.
Oh, wow, Machado, we're at
3-0
count.
And the move
count
to the pinch hitter will not pan out as that's taken in for the first down. Jason Bourgeois moving to the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning.
Swing 3-1, really.
Now a swing and another fly ball here as things are getting busy out there in
Central. A lot better than
and the pinch hitter will not be able to advance the cause, and there are two away now. Pedro Florimond will step in,
we'll
a ground out victim as last time.
Next
fastball
time
in there for a called strike.
If there's one guy on this roster who wants the ball in a moment like this, this is the guy.
Good
curveball,
strike two.
If I get it wrong, the walk off will be. I don't know what I was thinking.
Low and inside with the breaking ball as that causes him to back up a bit.
And even on 0-2, you don't want guys to get into a comfort level up there.
Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center.
Mud with
under
you
it,
there.
And he makes the catch for out number three. 1-2-3 go the Cardinals. No change in the score. It's 3-3.
3-3.
Manny Machado will stay in the ballgame now and take over
playing
in left field. David
Ortiz,
is set to go now as we lead off the bottom of the ninth.
Right.
Now a swing and a ground ball. This is foul for the first strike.
Most home run hitter cannot be having this performance. Can't. Unacceptable.
Now a cutter down around his shoe tops as he hops out of the way. Oh, look out now. Guys don't like it when you miss up and in like that. And you know what? That's not a big breaking ball coming up high and tight. That's going to get your attention a little. And he changed up on him here, but this is a foul ball.
Oh, yeah, no. That pitch was strange. I don't care if I swing a straight.
Here he comes on 2-2. Now here's a swing and a fly ball out to center for the new man just inserted into the ballgame.
I got two muscles on.
Bourgeois is right there, one down. David Ross will try again. 0-3.
Gonna make the last substitution of the night. Ross from Norris.
Move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate.
Or at least a base hit. Start a little rally.
And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. One out, nobody on. A swing and a little soft ground ball down the third. Picked up by his tourist. Throw gets him, two down.
All right, well, nice job.
It's looking more and more likely that we're going to need extra innings here to decide this one.
Colton Wong.
Oh, Colton.
Two away here as this one swung on and missed for the first strike.
Wow, no chance of getting on top of that fastball. I mean, that's helmet level right there.
Swinging a ball hit on the ground. And fielder will step on the bag. Three unassisted for Prince in the inning. Derek Norris will stay in the ball game as he'll likely do the catching from here out. Cesar Asturias will lead it off here in the top of inning number 10. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
It was a little loud. I was just calling the health bell.
Another fastball. Another cold strike. Nothing in two now.
Yeah, that pitch is still up a little bit, but at least this one was out on a corner. And I don't think I'd want to be making a living up there too much.
And a good effort on the dive that time, but this will get by him for a base hit.
Well, I think I'm about ready to declare his cold streak over.
Well,
he's broken out of it in a big way here. His third
up
hit
in here
of the ball game, and he looks as good as gold to my eyes.
Josh
Rutledge will be the first to stand in against the new pitcher, as he'll do so with the runner at first and nobody out.
Oh, I really
the bunt attempt back, but it's in there for strike one. Showing bunt, but he winds up taking ball one. Trying to get that go-ahead run to scoring position now as he puts this one down.
Couldn't turn it, but we got the lead run.
So they just get the one.
Well, they're trying to bunt that go-ahead base runner into scoring position, but this is great instincts to know you still got a shot at second base, so they take it. They come away with a force.
Trout is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. But they'll just get the one out here as the runner will get back safely at first. So it's a runner at first with two men out. And that'll bring in the slugging first baseman, Prince Fielder. A bit high there. A ball and no strikes. And that swung on and fouled straight back. There's a swing and the ball lifted to left, but back in the seats, out of play. It's one and two. And he strikes him out here for out number three.
Oh, he knocked him through. That's so straight, dude. That was right down the middle.
Wade Davis will come on here to start the home 10th, and all he's looking to do
is
get this
one to the 11th inning. Up now that I rallied for two runs in the 8th inning.
Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back.
Let's pretend it's the 8th inning guy.
And quick wrists here as this is yanked down the third baseline.
You don't really
throw to first by his Turris, one go.
Get out multiple times.
So the shortstop, Derek Jeter, will get another shot now. 2 for 3 in the game. Derek Jeter. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Come on, don't fail.
When that's upstairs like that, that's a pitch you got to leave alone and make him bring something down.
Make it 3.
Goodness.
No, not swinging it
back. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Still sticking with the fastball, but this time he lays off. It's 1-2.
And now, as a hitter, 1-2, you've got to be thinking right center field. But take a little swing out and try to drive something the other way.
And that misses 2-2.
So by me calling where I think the pitch is going to be, when it shows up right, I don't swing.
And here's a pitch swung on and sent on the ground to short. And he'll try for the stretch at first, but it gets right by him. Luckily, however, the first baseman will get his mitt on it, so there is no advance on the play. So a runner at first now with one away and set to stand in the still very imposing figure of the three-time MVP, Alex Rodriguez.
It's only if the pitch is high, then
that
it'll...
time as he's barely able to foul it away. A look at Jeter now, the pitch.
Oh,
he's
oh no, that was
his hand down.
Red.
It's 0-2.
I don't know why I swung it
there. That pitch was never going to be a strike.
Now he can't get him to bite this time. It's 1-2.
Now I'm even with my man.
If you've got him to reach for it, 0-1, maybe he'll do it again, 0-2.
To 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
That's a good location for that cutter. With
can't really
strikes.
See these here,
he's either got to take that, hope it's a ball, or he's got to foul that thing off.
Now a ball hit high and deep, heading toward the corner and left. And it in fact lands in the corner, foul.
Foul right in front of the pool.
Ready with another 2-strike offering. Gets under the fastball there and pops this one up. This is just beyond the infield on the right side. Therefore, it is Rutledge, and there are 2 away now. Billy Hamilton will step in. 1 for 4 in the ball game. And here's a ball lifted high into foul ground down the right field line.
Man.
And that hook's just foul. Boy, not by much more than an inch or two there. Off the plate, 1 ball, 1 strike.
And the reason he's working away so much here is because he's got that big hole on the right side of the infield to worry about. But you don't want to give this guy something where he can just roll over a ground ball and still get it into right field.
And he hits the corner with that one.
It showed up red. Well, I guess it means I picked right.
And a swing as he pulls this one into right. And that's in there. Base hit.
Trapped it.
Throw comes in quickly, but the winning run is in scoring position now with two away. Mike Trout will stand in now. Hitless to this point, but with a chance to be a hero here.
Well, he knows better than anybody in that lineup that one swing could make up for a whole game's worth of struggles.
Damn, it's to make the catch, up. And that means we've got more baseball.
Corey Hart will try and get something started here in the top half of inning number 11.
Luckily, last inning was Corey. I'm glad I got going. Hopefully, I can.
Now a ball hit towards Jeter. Throw to first by Jeter, and there's one gone.
So we're attempting. I'm not going like Kobe.
Brian McCann will try and erase his 0 for 4 in the ball game. Swinging a hard liner to center field.
We'll have this
round. Is there two gone?
If there is one. But he's getting outs quick.
Manny Machado will try it again. He flew out his first time. And a ball 1-0. One 0 pitch is a splitter in there. 1-1.
I think if you gave him another chance, he'd be swinging at that one. That was a great pitch to hit.
Good riding action to that thing, and it's ball and two strikes.
Very patient here to start the at-bat. Maybe even a little too patient because now...
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side.
I will see you later in the house.
Jose Bautista will get us going now in the home half of the 11th. And a pretty feeble effort that time as this is tapped in front of the mound.
It's like the dot in the top right. Makes it look like he's so much closer to the base.
Will stand in. He flew out his last time up. And now the second pitch of the inning is hit in the air to center. And now he has some trouble with it in center. The relay. And they've got a man caught in the
rundown. Oh my God, these buttons are so trippy.
Derek Norris will stand in. He grounded out his first time.
He's going to shoot something. Like, no, I'm not. I'm not going to shoot.
Odd couldn't lay off the pitch inside. It's 0-1.
Yeah, kind of a late decision to swing there. Even if he hits that thing, that might just be a routine fly to right.
Foul, you guys have no idea how much that friggin' pisses me off. Words are indescribable. How the button win the game for me. I have to go. So, thank you guys for watching, and I'll finish this game sometime soon.
Down in order go the Mets.
Later.
Still tied.